और नमन, शैल स्टार्ट।
हाँ
शैल स्टार्ट डॉट। Very good afternoon to one and all. A warm welcome to all of you to this virtual seminar on current trends in IoT. Let's begin the seminar with God's blessing. Our first year student Amrita R will sing an invocation song. Over to you, Amrita.
Pa sa sa ri ga ma pa ma ga ri sa ni sa ri. Pa sa sa ri ga ma pa ma ga ri sa ni sa ri. गणनायकाय गणदैवताय गणाध्यक्षाय धीमहि गुणशरीराय गुणमण्डिताय गुणेशानाय धीमहि गुणाधीताय गुणाधीशाय गुणप्रविष्णाय धीमहि एकदन्ताय वक्रतुण्डाय गौरीतनयाय धीमहि शेषानाय बालचंद्राय श्री गणेशाय धीमहि एकदन्ताय वक्रतुण्डाय गौरीतनयाय धीमहि गजेशानाय बालचंद्राय श्री गणेशाय धीमहि श्री गणेशाय धीमहि श्री गणेशाय धीमहि।
थैंक यू अमृता। Very good afternoon to one and all gathered here. Knowledge is power. With that note, I would like to welcome our beloved principal, Professor Jairama Reddy sir, principal, Government First Grade College, Malur. Without him, it is not possible for all of us to be here. The resource person, Aruna Devi ma'am, assistant professor, Department of Computer Science, PG, Kristu Jayanti College, Bengaluru. Thank you, ma'am, for accepting our request and for taking this initiative to enlighten and encourage young minds. Welcome you, ma'am. Professor Hemila ma'am, assistant professor, Department of Computer Science, Government First Grade College, Malu. I would like to thank you, ma'am, on behalf of all the students for organizing this event. Last but not the least, all teaching and non-teaching staff from all the departments and all my fellow friends are welcome to this program. Please note, all my fellow friends are requested to kindly mute your audios and videos. If you have any questions, you can put them in chat box. And finally, requesting all of you to submit the feedback form available in chat box at the end of this event. I would like to call Shilpa M.V. from final year to introduce our chief guest. Over to you, Shilpa.
Good afternoon, one and all. As we all know that now you are attending virtual seminar on Internet of Things. For this, I am inviting the great well-known resource person, Aruna Devi madam, and she is from Kristu Jayanti College, Bangalore. Aruna Devi ma'am has about nearly about 17 years of teaching experience in various institutions. Ma'am awarded as Staff of the Year 2009-2010 VHNSN College, Tamil Nadu. Apart from this, our qualifications that ma'am has completed her PhD Computer Science in Mother Teresa Women's University. Ma'am also completed Master of Computer Applications and Bachelor of Engineering. Aruna ma'am has professional experiences like lecturer, head assistant professor in computer science and information technology. Aruna ma'am handled classes for BCA, MCA, BSc, MSc and PGDCA, MBA and so on. Ma'am also handled for so many programming languages like C, C++, Python and so many. Aruna ma'am was presented papers in international and national conference. Aruna ma'am is being invited as a resource person for various colleges and university programs. It's a great privilege to have Aruna ma'am with us. Welcome you, ma'am. handing over the session to you, ma'am.
Thank you, dear students, for such a beautiful introduction. I hope I'm audible to you all.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am, you're audible.
Okay. So I'm really touched by the words of dear students, because I feel when I look at you, it's been long time to teach UG students mostly. I was taking to MCA students and many classes to teachers. So it was very nice to see like a small kids, how nicely you were organizing this event. So first, my hearty appreciation to each one of you. I would like to thank Government First Grade College Malu for giving me an opportunity to meet you all through this virtual seminar platform. I extend my thanks to Hamila ma'am also. So with this note, let me actually quickly move on to the seminar topic. Okay, so ma'am was asking regarding this seminar past week. So ma'am was telling about the students. So you are telling about how much effort you used to put, and even during the lockdown time, what and all you were doing, everything she was telling me. And she wanted, ma'am wanted actually, you all to be, expert in your particular domain. So we thought like maybe we can pick this IoT. So though you have a small introduction about IoT, maybe I can maybe take you through, little more further. In this particular area. Okay, so since it is a virtual seminar, I could not physically see you, I could not physically be with you. So you can stop me anytime if you have any doubts or something. You can unmute yourself or you can put it in the chat box. I hope the organizers will help me if I didn't notice the queries in the chat box. Okay, so I have planned my session this way. I'm going to start with the basics of what is IoT. Then I'm going to take you through the next level, which is the analytics and how this IoT and analytics can be used together and how the future applications demand this IoT analytics. Because now what is the purpose of learning? Why actually we are doing our undergrad, graduation, post-graduation, everything? We wanted to contribute something to the society. We wanted to do something. We want to invent something, discover something, right? So what and all is the expectation in the near future? So that is what we are going to see today. So anybody could define me what is IoT? Anybody has any idea what is IoT? You have learned something or you have heard about something?
Yeah, ma'am. IoT. IoT means Internet of Things. That's what we know.
Okay. Yes. Internet of Things. How it is different from our normal networking? So we know about all networking, isn't it? So we know about networking. So networking is like I'm getting responses from the students that it is Internet of Things. Very good. I'm happy about it. So when we say Internet of Things, how it is different from the traditional network? So when I say traditional network, the traditional network, what it has is you have a lot of computers connected together. You have some mobile phones which are connected together. But now we say Internet of Things. What do you mean by thing? Thing means thing. What and all I can call it as a thing. I can call my watch as a thing, right? As a product, right? I can call my water bottle, right? As a thing. I can call my bag as a thing. So all these things are these things, we call these items only as things, right? They are not devices, not they are simple device, right? So now how these things can be connected to internet? So very simple example I can take. So now I said that this is my water bottle, right? So my question is this water bottle can be connected to internet? If it is connected to internet, what is the advantage I will have? So now let me tell you. So now we have the Bangalore, Bangalore, Mysore, all these places, you know about the climate, right? Morning it will be very chill, and by noon it will be very hot. By evening again it will be chill. So the temperature is changing. So what I want is, I want my water bottle to give me water according to the temperature. Okay. So if that is possible, normal flask, what it does, if I fill it with hot water, it will give me hot water. If I fill it with cold water, it will give me cold water. But now here I want in a different way. Depends on my environment temperature, I want my water bottle to give me water. So how I can achieve this? How I can make it possible? So that is what we are moving into the next era. That means I want, yes, Vinit. Vinit, you want to share something?
No, ma'am.
Okay, fine. Okay, so what I can do, now what I can do, first thing, how do I know the temperature of my environment? I need to measure the temperature. So how do I do that? I should have a device that measures the temperature of the environment, of the room. And taking the temperature, now what I should do, if the temperature is this much, then I have to change the temperature of my water bottle water. So I should have an arrangement in that. So if I am connecting into a particular charger, so what happens is either I have to heat the water, I have to make it cool. So these are the possibilities I can do it, right? So all these things we call it as automation. So automatically it is going to give me. Okay, now how internet also comes into this water bottle. So now I'm going to say that, suppose whenever I want to drink the water, then I want the process should happen. It should give me cold water or hot water, it should give me. So when I want to drink the water, so I am going to send a message to my water bottle. I am going to drink water. So I want to drink 2 cups of water. So I am going to send a message. So my water bottle will make sure that it is having 2 cups of hot water or 2 cups of cold water. It looks very funny, right? When I say this, we will be laughing. Right, everybody, including myself, I'll be laughing when this will happen, when this water bottle can, interact with me. But soon after some time, whatever we think that it is funny or weird or something which is not going to happen, that will happen. That's the power of our technology. So that's the same thing which can be brought by the help of our Internet of Things. So Internet of Things is nothing but you have a system, okay, a system of interrelated devices, okay, mechanical, it can be a mechanical device, digital machines, objects, animals, or people, anything can be interconnected, okay. When I'm interconnecting, what I should do, suppose if I'm connecting my computer to internet, then what it should have? It should have an IP address, right? You would have studied in your networking paper. You will run a protocol called as TCP/IP protocol. So why this IP address is there? Because see, every one of us are having names, right? So how I will be calling you? By your name. How teacher will be calling you? By your registration number. So same way, whenever we are going to a public place, we will be called by our name. So similarly, whenever these devices are going to internet, it should have a number or it should have a unique name. That is what they call it as unique identifier. So a computer is having MAC address, it is having some IP address and all. Similarly, your phone is having. Like that, if I am connecting my things, right, Internet of Things, so what will happen is that thing, whatever is the thing, it should have a identifier. So that I can call, right? So now, how do I call you people? By looking at the Zoom ID. So I can see the Zoom ID name. So with that, I will be calling you. Similarly, the device also should have identifier. And what else it should have? It should also have the ability to transfer data over the network without requiring human-to-human or human-to-computer interaction. So it means that you are going to directly interact. The device is directly going to interact without any help of a human being. So if I'm saying that water bottle, I want water. So I get a message from my water bottle saying that yes, water is available. Or it will say water is not available. So it is responding to me automatically without any human interference. So that era we are into it. Okay, so let's one more time see the definition. What is Internet of Things? It's actually a system, okay, of interrelated computing devices, okay, with the mechanical digital machines, and it could be an object or animal or people which are provided with unique identifier, and also it will have the ability to transfer data. So what is the advantage of network? Network advantages, you will be able to share the data, you will be able to transfer the data, isn't it? So that is what they are saying. This is the general definition. But when I say this IoT thing and all, mainly what actually we are trying to do? We are trying to look at the environment and decide something. So they say that mainly whenever we say IoT, what comes to our mind is the sensor. What do you mean by sensor? So we said the bottle should sense the temperature. So it should have a sensor for that. Otherwise, it should sense some light. It should sense some air pollution or something that way. So it should have some input devices. What are the input devices it should have? It should have a sensor. What are the types of sensors available globally? Sensors available, few I have listed, which is actually used in the global market. So starting from temperature, you can measure. You can also sense the motion or velocity or displacement. What do you mean by motion? So for example, in the phone you would have seen, right? So what happens is accelerometer, they say the more you shake the phone, automatically its arm will change. All these options are all available, right? So that is possible with the help of a sensor. Similarly, you have humidity or moisture sensor. For what purpose I have to measure humidity? Let's take a very simple example. A simple example is maybe you want to go for a automatic smart forming. So smart forming is what? I want to pour the water wherever it is dry. Wherever it is wet, I don't want to do that. So what I can do, I can keep some sensor which measures the moisture and humidity in the particular place. So when it goes very, very dry, then you get a notification. Automatically we can sprinkle the water. Okay, so that is what they call it, a smart forming. Similarly, you can also measure the light. Also, you can measure the flow of something. You can also measure sound. Listening to the sound, you can actually detect something. Not only that, you can also sense the chemical, gas, or position, which place it is available, then vibration, acceleration, ultrasound, like that, lot of sensors available. So whichever is needed for your application, you can use those sensors. You can pick whichever you need actually, and then you can use them for creating the application. So I am starting with one simple application to understand the power of the IoT. So here you can see in this example, there is some block diagrams given. So it starts from the left hand side. So what if there is somebody, if someone's hand is there, okay, in the hand you can see they are wearing some smart watch something, okay, and they say that this watch will measure. It may be a watch or a device, but that measures, you know, some values from the human body. Okay, it's going to measure like BP, pressure, and blood glucose, like that. It is going to measure something. And what it is going to do actually, after measuring this value, it is going to transfer this data. Why it has to be transferred? So let me take a very simple example. You would have heard about ICU, right? What is ICU? ICU is intensive care unit, right? In hospitals and all, we have seen ICU where they admit patients. They will say why they are admitting is they want to continuously monitor the patient. What they will monitor? Every 1 hour, they may measure BP, sugar, all these things. Every 1 hour, they may measure something and all, because the person has to be under control. The person has to be under monitoring. His value has to be recorded. Suppose if there is a change in the BP, suppose the BP is going low, then immediately the doctor should pay attention. Or if the BP is going high, then he has to be given with tablet. So these things and all, it is not what we are doing. We are having one hospital, one room is there for the patient is sitting there, and one nurse is visiting, and then doing all these things. Okay, fine. But I don't want to keep the patient in the hospital, but I want the same kind of treatment. So what can we do? We can keep the patient in the home. And then again one nurse is there. So how furthermore I can move on? So what I can do is, you give the device to the patient, measure the value, every 1 hour send the value, and in the distance, the doctor will be monitoring the value. If the value is going out of the boundary, either less or high, then immediately the doctor has to visit, or he has to do some kind of alternative arrangement to take care of the patient, right? So all these things are all possible with the help of IoT. So here you can see, it is saying that there is a end side, that is your patient is there. Then we have wearable wireless system. So wearable wireless system is nothing but I'm having something, I'm wearing something which has some electrodes and sensor which captures the signal, and it is transmitting. Transmitting to where? It is transmitting to your control system. In that control system, what actually they are doing, they are capturing the signal and then they are checking whether it is under control or not under control. If it is not under control, then there is one system called as warning system. This warning system will call the doctor's phone or nurse or caretaker or a primary healthcare center to pay attention to the patient. Okay. So here, why I am calling this as an IoT system? You may be telling, okay, is this possible with a normal microcontroller or something? Yes. Why we are calling this as IoT is, these device, this particular device, the wearable, is connected to internet. Okay. And the data is transmitted from one location to another location. And the decision is made in the distant location. And there are other features also, like calling and everything is available across the internet. So that's the reason we say that it is Internet of Thing, Internet of Thing application, right? So this is one simple application. Now we are all seeing everybody are wearing the fitness watch and all, right? So that value is stored in some, Google Fitness or wherever is it, right? The same way. So that is possible with the help of the internet. So we will further move on, right? This is not only the beginning. It has crossed so many milestones. Let us see what happens in the near future. So they say that now people are having more IoT devices. Many people are having smartwatches, and not only smartwatches, even now you can see that yesterday I read in the news, Samsung has released a new fridge. Which actually can send message like that everywhere, not only in fridge, even for microwave oven and so many other devices are getting connected to internet, right? So now how do we what happens in near future? So they say that you can see a small graph which says the number of active device connections across the world. So what happens is, the number of devices which are connected to the internet is growing like anything. Okay, in 10 years of time, you can see that the value has been up from 3.8 to 21.5, a number of billion connections. So what happens, how do we handle this value? So this is a prediction, in 2025, this much is possible. Okay, the red shaded ones are IoT devices and the dashed line boxes non-IoT device. Okay, so we say that the number of devices are going to be more. So when more and more devices are there, what happens? More amount of data will be generated. What do you mean by that? Suppose you assume you have a simple attendance register. Okay, in the class there are some 30 people. Then what happens, I can use one page to write. Suppose 60 students are there, then I need two pages. Suppose 120 students are there in a class, I need to have 4 pages. Am I right? When the number of students are more, then number of pages I have to keep is also more. So same thing with respect to the I device also. When the number of devices is more, then what happens? The data will give, the device will give data, that also will go. So I have large amount of data. How I will handle this data? What is the solution? To say that, we are moving to the next level, that is connected to smart. What is the difference between connection and smart? Suppose if the device is connected, is it meaning that the device is smart? No. Right? I have a mobile phone. The mobile phone has internet connection. So can I call this mobile phone as a smart device? I cannot call this as a smart device until and unless it works according to my requirement. So I cannot say my device is smart. So now we say that we have to make the device smarter. So I have my IoT device. I want to bring some artificial intelligence. Okay, what is artificial intelligence? I have to bring some intelligence, right? What is that intelligence? What we can call it as intelligence? What is intelligence? So let me take one example. Yes, I think somebody is responding. Krishna has responded. AI is artificial intelligence. So very good. Okay. So what is this actually intelligent? When we say AI, are we saying that the current machines are not intelligent? Are we saying that? What's the difference between intelligence and instruction or a program? So let me take very simple example. Can any one of you give me steps to make coffee? Who knows to make coffee better?
Control C, ma'am. Coffee, how to do?
I'm asking drinking coffee. How do I make coffee?
Yes, ma'am. Take one cup of milk and then add little amount of water. Then add the sugar. Later, little bit boil that milk, and then we can add the coffee powder. Then again boil that. Then coffee will be ready.
Okay, very good, very good. I think you are an expert in making coffee. Okay, but you assume that I am not at all an expert. I don't know how to make coffee. So I have listened to you now. So you told me to take milk. So I have taken 1 liter of milk. I have taken 1 liter because you said take milk, right? So I have taken. Then you said add little water, right? So little means how much?
It should be below, less than amount of milk.
Right. That you know, but I don't know. So I, according to me, whatever is little, I will add the water. Then you said add sugar. Okay. But you are an expert, so you said add sugar. But I don't know how much sugar I have to add. So what will I do? I will take the sugar dabba. That box, the entire box, I will dump into the milk. Correct.
No.
So, because that's the reason I'm telling, because I am a beginner. I don't know how to make coffee. I'm not an expert. Okay. So I have just dumped it. It means that I don't have that kind of intelligence. Now, earlier, how we used to do programs is, we will say, this is the instruction you follow. Correct? You write a C program. Include stdio.h, void main. You will say declaration. Then you will say this is arithmetic operation, logical operation. So whatever you say in the program, only that is followed by the computer. Suppose you say the computer to go and jump into water. Computer will go and jump into water without thinking that it will be killing the computer. Right? If it dumps into water, what happens? So it will be spoiled, right? So without knowing that, the computer will do that. Now what is this AI is? AI, certain things, if we have not given instruction. then this AI will find out what is actually can be done. Though it has not been given, though the instruction is not given, the system with the AI will find out which is correct, which is not correct. Okay, humans are having the intelligence. When she told me add sugar, so I know that I have to add sugar, which is only 1 spoon or 2 spoon. But the computer will not have the knowledge. The devices will not have the knowledge. So we are going to bring the smartness into the device. So that is going to be the next level. Okay, so it does not mean that if it is connected, it is not a smart. If I am saying IoT, then it is not a smart device. I have to make the device a smart. So you would have heard about IEEE. Okay, it is a global organization, global forum, where people used to discuss about upcoming technologies. So I have 2 slides. One is for the past year, that is top 12 technology for the year 2020, and also I have for 2021. I generally show the current year, but I want to show previous year also because of few reasons. Okay, so now you can see I have listed down top 12 technology trends for 2020. So the first one, you can see that it is AI at the edge. It is given as AI at the edge. So it is what is actually AI at the edge? Towards the end, you will come to know what is AI at the edge. Okay, now let's see, there are something which is given: non-volatile memory products, digital twins, AI and critical systems, practical delivery drones. There are so many things which they have given, that those things are the trends of 2020. But due to the lockdown and other things, we have not achieved most of this. We have not, though we were working, we have not achieved. Now look at that, when I see this, when I have just randomly going through, I can see most of it has this word called AI. And the first definition, first keyword itself, it is AI at the edge. Now let's see what it is. And this is the top 5 technology which is being predicted for the year 2021. So they have given that, remote workforce technology, social distancing technology, reliability and safety for intelligent autonomous system, synthetic data for training, machine learning systems, like that they have given a lot of things. Okay, so here also when I go through it, what I can see is they are talking about the devices. Okay, look at the second one. Because of the COVID reason, they are talking about social distancing technology. So what is that social distancing technology is? See, earlier, suppose you want to use hand wash. Okay, hand wash, how you have used it, it will be there, you will be pressing and you will be using it. But now, in the other countries, people are worried to touch the hand wash. So they say that, oh no, I don't want this thing. I want automatic, hand wash dispenser. It means that I will show the hand, automatically I should get the hand wash in my hand. So in India, what we are doing, we are employing people to do that. In foreign countries, when they want to go for an automation, what actually they do, they will have one automatic sensor that will sense, is there a hand? Okay, if there is a hand, then it will open the particular wall and it will spill like 1 ml, 2 ml of dispenser. Okay, so that is how it is, automation is being done, right? So the social distancing technology related. One second. Sorry. So, the social distancing technology. So, what we want is We don't want to touch the device, but then we want things to happen. Okay. I think Krishna has again responded that it should have the ability to think. Okay, now, yes, what we want is actually the device, which mainly focuses on the social distancing technology. So the device should think, the device should learn something, it should think automatically, and it should work accordingly. So that is what we can do. What we can do is we can have, a kind of device or a framework, that helps us to have a social distancing. Okay, so some kind of apps or wearables or sensors. So this is one thing which I find that something related to IoT. Like that, even you can see autonomous system. So you would have seen some drones. What do you mean by drone? Something which actually flies and captures and all, right? So that kind of drones. So that drones and all, what it can do is intelligent drones. It means that, suppose you feed a location where it has to, supply some data, supply some items. I'm ordering some vegetables. So it has to fly and then it has to deliver. So that and all is possible. So that kind of autonomous system. So this is how we are actually moving to the next era of technology. Okay. So today I have taken, the topic which is given to us is current trends in IoT. So I have taken this AI at the edge, which is nothing but IoT analytics. Okay, so we have understood what is actually IoT, the device which is being connected to the network, that we have actually understood. Now let's see how these devices can be intelligent. How can we make the devices intelligent? So that is what we are going to look in. For that, we should have some little knowledge about what is AI. So AI, everybody has some idea that we are saying that the machine has to think. How the machine has to think. Now let me take one simple example. So the simple example is, now we have seen mobile phones with face recognition. What do you mean by that? So I'll just open my phone, I'll show my face, then automatically the phone should get unlocked, right? So how is that possible? So it is taking a photo of me. Already the mobile is having my photo. It is comparing these two photographs and if both are same, then it opens, it unlocks, right? So now most of the phones are having the feature. Now my question is, what happens over the year, my face will get changed, right? After 10 years, my face will not be the same as like this. There will be little changes, but my features are going to be same. How the system will identify with the photograph which is 10 years older? But a person, if I see you today, if I'm taking class for you, after 10 years, if I see, I can actually call you, I can address you. But that is not possible with our, mobile. The mobile cannot do that. Why? Then what I can do for the mobile? So I should train my mobile that, see, there is a person who is in the age of 1, 2, 3, 4. Like that, I should give some example to the person and I should train. So how is that possible? Recently, I think last year I have seen everybody were posting in the Facebook 10 year challenge. Everybody were posting their photograph 10 years before and current year. So what Facebook was doing? Facebook was taking all the sample and give to the system and say, see, this is the person who looked like before 10 years and this is how they are looking now. So this is the 10 year difference of the picture. Okay, so now the same thing what we have to do is you are giving the intelligence to the machine. So the machine keeps looking at the sample like book reading. Okay, so you have given some algorithm. So the algorithm will take this sample and it will read the sample and it will finally understood that, okay, a person after 10 years he will be looking at that. So it can predict that way. Okay. So these kind of concepts we are putting together, we call it as AI. So for having a machine with AI, what are the technologies we have to incorporate? So you would have heard about something called as neural network, natural language processing, deep learning, machine learning, cognitive computing. So what all these things are there? So So let me take one by one. So first of all, I can pick the very simple thing, that is computer vision. So right now, what example we spoke is the computer vision example. So computer vision example is that, you see the, image before 10 years, after 10 years, and then recognize. So that is what you call it as a computer vision. Computer is having a vision. It is looking at and then it is identifying. Okay, so that kind of technology. Then that is possible with machine learning. We were telling about learning. That is, I am giving the photographs of 10 years before and after to the machine. So the machine is reading, the machine is learning using some algorithm. Then neural network. So we all of us know that we are doing everything because of the brain. The brain is helping us to understand something, to read something, to perform something, isn't it? So the same way here also, we are going to consider our computer as an artificial neural network. Your program is going to work like an artificial neural network. So how I can change my normal program into an artificial neural network program? So the program will work according to how the brain works. Okay, how the brain actually works. Very simple example. When we do this tables, you may remember the table. What is table? You will remember 2 into 2 is equal to 4. 3 into 2 is equal to 6. All these things, I remember when I studied the table, I don't even know that 3 into 2 is equal to 6. This is 3 plus 3. That we call it as repeated addition. But we simply look at the table, we used to by heart and we used to write in the examination. So we call it as by heart, right? We say by heart is not good because you are not taking any meaning of it. But your brain can still work. How is that possible? It is actually learning by pattern recognition. So pattern is nothing but whenever these two numbers are coming with multiplication, this should be the result. So that is how your brain actually thinks. So that we call it as a neural network. And then we have deep learning. So deep learning is the next level of your neural networks. Okay. And natural language processing. So what is that natural language processing? It is understanding the meaning. So nowadays you can see that people are writing so many things in the Facebook, writing so many things in Instagram, Twitter, or forget about it in WhatsApp itself, people are sending messages. How many messages are true? How many messages are false? We don't know, right? So if there is a system which can read the text and find out whether it is true or not, that would be good, isn't it? So that is what we say, natural language processing. Okay, so NLP will help you. It will help to read the particular sentence and understand the meaning of it and also to make a decision of it. So there is a lot of demand for this AI. Okay, very simple thing is you can take in the industry and you can also take in example like surveillance, and you can also take example like driving. Now earlier and all we had a normal car. Now then came automatic cars. Now we are moving to the next level, driverless cars. Right? So Tesla is working on driverless car. So all these things, how actually they are doing, they are combining artificial intelligence, IoT together, and not only that, other technologies also along with that. So that is termed as your edge computing. So now let's see what is actually edge computing and how it is being different, and we'll take one example case study of it. Okay, so edge computing, we have heard about cloud computing. So what is cloud computing? You have a car, camera, traffic signal, mobile, and all these things are connected to my cloud. So I will send the data to cloud, it will be stored in the cloud, and computation will be happening here. What do you mean by computation? Addition, subtraction, multiplication, or decision taking, anything is possible. Okay, but what is edge computing? Is the data is referred in the cloud, but computation does not happen in the cloud. The computation happens in the device. It means what? The car will have a computer. Your traffic signal will have a computer. Your video camera will have a computer. So that will perform the computation and gives the result. So that is what they say, computation. Okay, so that is the place where your computation takes place. So we say that, so what happens here is, it actually brings the computation and data storage closer to the location where it is needed. So in the car only, I want to perform a computation. So there is a data which is generated in the car. It is being processed in the car itself. Okay, so that is the reason they have got a name called as edge computing. Okay, now they say one thing, they were talking about this analysis and analysis. Let's make the point very clear what is analysis and then let's move on. I think you are familiar with Facebook. So when I go to Facebook and then when I type this my friends, what happens? This is someone else's profile. They are getting these kind of lists. It lives in San Francisco. Who likes surfing? Who went to Florida? So how these things are coming? Automatically it is coming. Similarly, you have seen there is a website, Amazon.in. People used to go and do online purchases. So here in this example, you can see that. So I have actually done an online searching. So I just checked for one particular watch. So you can see this is the watch I'm looking at it. On the top, you can see I looked for a watch, Titan. And you can see it has an oval dial and it has the frame colors gold. Now what happens is down I can see customers who view this item also view. I can see some watches are displayed. Look at the watches. They are also in gold color. They are also having that oval dial. Correct? So it is quite similar to these two. Okay. So what happens is the computer is understanding my demand. So this is my favorite. This one only I like. So whatever I like, according to that, they are giving me suggestion. So all these things are possible with the help of data analytics. So data analytics, what actually they do is they do an analysis. What is that, ma'am? Everybody are telling me. So let me take a very simple example. You go to your shop, neighboring shop, for taking a dress. So frequently you are visiting the shop. So what happens? The person will look at you, okay? Immediately he will judge for what reason you would have come to take dress. Okay, so he will be saying, okay, you have come to take dress for New Year, you have come to take dress for your Diwali, or if you have come to take dress for Sankranti. So based on the occasion, he will give you the dresses. Okay, the person is having the intelligence to identify what is the occasion we have come for taking the dress, and also he knows that he knows about you. Right, so he will immediately, okay, this color will suit you. You take this color and you take this dress because you are thin, you wear this kind of dress. Like that, and all they used to give you a recommendation. So we sincerely take the recommendation and then only we will do the purchase. That will be helping us a lot. So that is the same thing we want to bring into the computer also. The computer should give me recommendation. Okay, how that person, how the neighboring shop person knows about your taste, knows about your budget, because you are frequently going to the shop and you are purchasing from them. He knows about you, he knows about your mom, he knows about your dad, so he is giving you suggestion, right? So the same way, so here what we can do is, the computer also needs some data. So if it gets the data, like the same shop person gets the data, so even the computer also can give you suggestion. So the most important ingredient for the data analytics is the data. So I should give the data. What data I should give? I should give the, whatever is my interest, what is my parents' interest, everything. Everything is the data. So all these data is given to some program. So here we call them as the algorithm. Okay, so those algorithms will take this data and it will create a pattern. Pattern is nothing but the knowledge. So based on the data, it will say this person likes this kind of color. This person likes these kind of dress. Like that, it will come to a conclusion. That is a pattern. Okay, so as I promised you, we are going to merge these two. That is IoT and analytics. Okay, so what is that IoT and analytics? So we saw there is a challenge in the IoT that in the upcoming years, the number of devices which are connected to the internet will go up. So IoT analytics is nothing but the application of data analysis tools and procedures to realize value from large amount of data. So what happens is I have a lot of IoT devices. All the devices are giving me data. So taking the data, I want to do some analysis. Okay, so IoT analytics is going to do that only. So it is application of data analysis tool. It is going to use the analysis tool, okay, to get some knowledge from the data. And from where I am getting the data? From the IoT devices. Okay, so I need to check with my IoT data how my data is coming. And based on that only I have to make a decision. So how this process will happen? So if I take that process, so I can say that it all starts from the input. Input from where I am going to get the input? From the sensors. So the sensors are giving me data. That data I am going to put it in the database. Then that data will be transmitted across the network. Okay, so I think we can quickly move on. Yes, I have taken a case study. Okay, the video analytics for surveillance and safety. Okay, so this is going to be high demanded application. Why it is high demanded application? Now see, everywhere I can see the CCTV camera, right? So if I'm taking in my college itself, I can see in each floor we have a lot of cameras. Okay, now what these cameras will do? They are capturing the signal and storing somewhere. Now suddenly I need to check the camera. Maybe something which happened, maybe somebody lost their bag. So I want to check it in the CCTV. So what I should do in the CCTV? So the person will say, I don't remember the time. But approximately during the lunch break, I have just gone. Then what we will do, we'll take the camera. We will look at the stored video and we will just open that particular day, that particular duration time, and we will manually see the video like this. And then we will see, okay, what is happening? The girl is going, okay, where is that particular girl? Okay, I'll be waiting. And one moment that girl is crossing, okay, I'm seeing. And the girl is carrying the bag. Okay. So at that particular time, the girl was carrying the bag. For doing this, what I'm doing, I'm manually doing it. I'm manually opening the recorded video and then identifying where when the girl is coming. After that, I'm just looking whether the girl is having a bag or not. So every time this is done manually. Is there any possibility? Can we do with automation? Yes. If the cameras are having intelligence. So that is what we are going to do. It is having a high demand. So I think that even you can take some ideas as your project ideas and you can work on it. What and all is there a demand about the video analytics for the surveillance? So first thing is, we are dividing this entire operation. That is a camera, and the camera will look at the crowd. Okay, it will say it is crowded, it is not crowded. Queue management. So queue management is, suppose if I say that in the particular queue only these many people should be there, so it will say okay, the queue is full. It will automatically lock the gate. That is possible. Then people counting. So it can count how many people actually they are crossing. Right, in the gate, in college gate today, these many people have come in, these many people have gone out. So this should be given by my camera. People scattering. So how many people are scattered? There is one person alone standing there in one remote location. I want to find out. Or people tracking. Tracking is nothing but one person who started from the gate and then went to the main block, then went to the classroom, then went to canteen, then again classroom. This kind of tracking. Okay, so that and all is called the people management techniques. Okay, apart from that, we have vehicle management. What is vehicle management? So my camera should say, today these many two wheelers have crossed, these many four wheelers have crossed, and these many sedan vehicles they have crossed. Like that's the category of vehicles. Traffic monitoring and also license plate recognition. People used to know what the traffic people used to do. Suppose somebody is violating the traffic rule, they immediately capture the photograph of the nameplate and they will say, okay, this is the nameplate, we have to put a fine. Okay, if there is one camera itself which can do this, then it would be great help. So the camera will capture the nameplate and it will automatically send this data into the server saying that this particular vehicle has to be fined for this purpose. Okay, so like that we can have as many vehicle management techniques. And apart from that, we have behavioral monitoring. Behavioral monitoring is I can identify the face and I can say that, okay, a suspicious person is moving. So very simple example is, recently one of our students' project was with this. In police station, they will have some people photographs and all, saying that these people you have to be careful, right? So that faces and all will be given to this application automatically. And suppose if I am walking and if that person is moving around, okay, it will give me an alert saying that, see, there is a person who is in the warning list is around you. Okay, so like this, there are many things we can do. Suspicious activity detection. Somebody who is walking and monitoring to something. Okay, so kind of in the railway station, a person is continuously walking and monitoring somebody. So these kind of things and all can be captured by the camera and that can be notified to the police station. So these kind of things and all is possible. Okay, so for doing this video analytics, what I can do, how I can do. So first thing we said that input. What is going to be input here? The input is going to be either recorded video or a live stream video. So currently the video is captured and this video can be used as the input. So these are the two options I can take it as the input. And what's the next thing I can do? What and all we can do is, you can see one application here. You can see that there are people who are walking in the queue and the people are labeled. Can you see it's been labeled as DLP, missing person, vulnerable person, person of interest. So I want to check, for example, in the airport, suddenly a person is coming and showing the photograph. Just find out if that person is there in the airport, immediately we have to catch the person. So then what we can do, we can give this as an input to CCT. CCT can take this photograph and identify if there a person with that. And immediately it can say the person is there in this particular area. So this is what you call it as object identification using facial recognition features. Then the next thing is the combination of video analytics with other tagging and tracking. So tagging and tracking is nothing but, see, most of us are doing unknowingly. In the Facebook, when you're posting something, you're posting with a geographical location. So immediately it will say this particular day, this particular person was here, right? So you're just giving the location based data. So here, what are we trying to do is, we can feed our location-based data also along with the video analytics. And the next thing is a little complex technology, which we call it as micro-expression analysis. This is to identify a person is happy or sad or angry or scared, surprised. Like that I want to identify. So I want to identify emotion of a person looking at the face. So that and all is possible. So that is called micro expression analysis in video analytics. Okay. So now if I'm constructing one video analytics system. So video camera is a IoT device. Why suddenly I call it as IoT device? Because it is going to capture the signal and transmit to server. Okay, so this is IoT device. This is going to send the data for analysis. So we can see that the first input starts from here, feeding the system. So we are going to give the input from CCTV cameras, traffic cameras, and online video feeds. And the second thing is central processing versus edge processing. I have to decide whether the processing will take place in the CCT itself or it will happen in the server. And the third thing is we have to define the scenario and training model. So what do you mean by that? So now I have to give a training to my camera to identify. What are the basic training I'm going to give? That comes in the fourth one, task. What and all is given? Image classification. So image classification is to identify the category of an image from the set of predefined categories. So looking at that, I will say this is a car, this is a person, this is a house, this is a scissor, like that. Or I can say this is a moving object, this is a static object. Like that, I am going to label the items. Okay, and then localization. So localization is nothing but you are going to locate the object with a boundary. So I am going to say this is the human. Okay, so I'll identify the edge and I will say this is a person, this is an animal. Okay, so like that I am going to draw the boundary also. Then object reduction. So object reduction is nothing but you are going to locate and categorize an object which is in the image. So now looking at the image, I will say, okay, so there is one ball here, there is one apple here, and I also have to say that a person is walking, a girl is eating. Then object tracking. So object tracking is nothing but track an object which actually moves over the time. So that is one use case. I think we have ma'am, Hamila ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, can I take 5 more minutes or we'll have a question answer, ma'am?
Yes, ma'am.
So I'll take another example. This is also having a great demand. Sorry for taking 5 more minutes. Okay. Yeah, I'll quickly complete. So this is all about self-healing machinery system. So what I mean by self-healing machinery is, so if I take an example, for example, your TV, okay? Your TV is there, suddenly your TV, one day something happened, it automatically switched off, and then you are taking to the technician. Technician, he's saying that, okay, something has gone, and it needs 1 week time to repair the TV. So now what we are doing is, instead of knowing this at the end, what we can do is we can keep some supporting system in the device that actually will monitor, and it has to give me a message at least a week before saying that the system is having some trouble. It will get shut down in 1 week, or sometime it is going to get an issue. Then what happens is, then immediately I will come to know that the machine is having some problem, and then I have to call the technician immediately. So knowing the problem in advance. So that is what we call it as the diagnosing. And not only diagnosing, self-healing. So self-healing is nothing but after diagnosing that this is the problem. Okay, whether is it possible to be repaired automatically or should we call the technician? So this has to be taken. This choice has to be taken. So that kind of features are implemented in machineries. What type of machineries? You would have seen in hospitals. They have some EEG scanner, ECG scanner, like that and all. They will have some big machines. When you go and ask, I want to take one MRI. One MRI itself, they will say 4,000 rupees. Minimum, I don't know exactly, but they will say approximately 4,000 rupees. In a day, they may be taking some minimum 10 MRI. So the machine is giving 40,000. It is earning 40,000 per day. Okay, that machine suddenly, if it fails, and the technician is saying that, okay, another 10 days I will take to repair, then imagine the loss. Not only monetary loss, also the patient also will have kind of. What can be done is, if that machinery is having some provision, to identify that what is going wrong suddenly, because all on a sudden the machine will not do some issue. So it will be detected prior, unless and until it is some kind of power surge or something. If we will have a notification, this device it is not giving the normal voltage value, it is not giving the normal current value. So we need to do some kind of diagnostic and self-healing. So again, this is also one type of IoT analytics system. Like that, there are lots and lots of applications are available. Lot and lots of frameworks are available. So only thing what actually we need is, we have lot of programming, we have lot of devices. But what is missing in all the programs and devices is the intelligence. The intelligence is only from the human being. So ideas, intelligence, these are in high demand in the industry. Not only in industry, in everywhere. So these are the ideas, actually little bit of ideas. I will not say that I have shared everything with respect to IoT analytics. I have shared a little bit about IoT analytics to you. You can explore lot and lot of things with respect to it, and you can come up with your own framework or own model, and you can contribute to the society. Okay, so I'm stopping here, and I would like to hear from you. Any doubts or any clarification, anything, I'm open for you.
Friends, if you have any questions, you can put them in chat box. Ma'am, my question was, what are the higher studies opportunities in this field?
I can say opportunities and higher studies. I will say that nowadays, you can go for MCA or MSc Computer Science, but now if you ask me, more than studies, the industry is demanding your expertise. What do you mean by expertise? For example, if my interest is IoT, okay, there are some courses like MSc in IoT, but industry does not prefer that way. What they say is, you study anything. You study BSc Physics or MSc Computer Science, whatever. But what is your knowledge in it? So how do I prove my knowledge? I should have studied this subject. The advantage of having a master degree is, it is a proof. It is showing that these papers are not studied. Okay. But more than, it is not only from there. You can study something through online courses, or you can do some projects and you can contribute. Now, we have to be very happy about the hackathons which are happening nowadays. You may be seeing a lot of notices about hackathons happening. Hackathons not only in the college, I'm saying about in companies, even in the websites. There are a lot of hackathons happening. So you can just participate, you can share the ideas. Nowadays, what is more expected is the ideas. Why ideas? Because the program can program itself. We are in that era. What do you mean by that? What do you mean by that is, for example, there is a software called as RapidMiner, which actually we use for data validation. What actually it does is, you don't need to write a single line of code. No need to write a single line of code. Okay? What you want to do? For example, you want to construct artificial neural network. You just drag and drop an operator that will do the work of an artificial neural network. You don't need to write a single line of code. That kind of supporting tools are nothing but software. That many softwares are available. What industry is expecting from you is, you should have a creative ideas. You should come up with innovative practice, which is what industry is requiring. Because we have reached our saturation point. We have everything now. We need to invent what is our demand. Earlier, we know this is my demand, but right now we don't know what actually we want, because we have enough in hand. So they require, industry requires people with creative ideas. That ideas would help them in business, that ideas would help the society. So lot of demands are there for IoT. I was telling about video surveillance. For that itself, lot of demands, lot of projects. Suppose you have some ideas, you can write some code, then industry is open for you. There is no kind of age restriction or a degree restriction. They want whether you can implement this or not. So develop your expertise. There are a lot of online resources are also available. You can start from learning what is microcontroller, then moving on to the next level, you can learn about Arduino and other systems, and then we can move on to the next level. Like that you can progress yourself.
Thank you, ma'am. Ma'am, and one of the participants was asking, what is a disadvantage? Because the radiation will get more like that.
Yeah, I can see. But nowadays what happens is, they have a different category of devices. What do you mean by category is, now you can see in the mobile phones are restricted, right? They have some restricted radiation. This is the standard they have to follow. If that machine is not following that standard, it would be actually captured and they'll boycott those kind of machines. Similarly, biological sensors are different, normal sensors are different. You may be having a normal temperature sensor, but the temperature sensors with the IoT things and all, they have a kind of restriction. Because it's a beginning. IoT is a beginning actually. So they are actually creating the support system that helps biologically very, very friendly to us. How to improve the knowledge in this field? Okay, that's what I said. First, what you can do is you identify what is actually your strength, which one you are actually good in. You are good in hardware or you are good in software thing. So whichever is your strength. Are you good in writing programs? Okay, identify your strength and then work accordingly. For example, if I'm very much knowledge in microprocessor and microcontroller. So what I can do is I can work on that particular area, identifying the devices like Arduino, Lego, like that. Lot of devices are available. So what I can do is I can work on the programming on that particular machine. Suppose I'm not good in hardware, ma'am, but I'm good in this, software. So what you can do is you have some ready-made devices available. So ready-made devices means that will have everything. Even if you take Arduino comes with all the accessories. So you can buy those things and then you can write only the code level. So code level in the sense, you can go for Raspberry Pi, like that you can just, identifying the expertise and then you can work on it. I think we have ideas on innovation. What are the things available to show our innovation? It's a very, very nice question. I really appreciate because as I told you, nowadays you people are actually wanted for your own thoughts. Thoughts in the sense I was telling just before about the automatic dispenser, right? The hand wash dispenser, right? So recently in our college, so we have actually installed the automatic, dispenser. Like that, this will vary with respect to time. It may be a small product or it may be a big one. Small product in the sense I can install in the college, or even I can go for the next level, selling neighboring areas. I can also sell it for nearby hotels. Right, there are some hotels I can sell this if I'm making it in a cheaper price. Like that, you can think in the next level because now government is also encouraging to start our own business. Okay, so instead of going for some other's ideas, if you have these kind of ideas, first you develop one prototype. Simply, if you go and tell someone, they will not believe. Right, you need to show that this is a working model. So you need to implement one small prototype. Some working model and then take it and look for a business. Either you only do the business or you can go to the next level and you can actually, you need to have a lot of collaboration. You need to identify the current demand and then you have to sell accordingly. For example, if it is already available and I am making and I am selling these, no customer will be there because people will prefer to get from the standard brand things. But if it is new, nobody has used, then there is always a demand. There is always a demand. I can see that there is one application, I remember it is Dropers, some application which helps us to order online vegetables. Initially that one only came. And then slowly what happens? that what happens is they'll develop a particular application. When it has a large demand, obviously it goes to the big people now. Like Amazon will start buying these kind of apps and all. So you develop something, automatically people will come to you to buy your product. So you don't need to worry about it. You have ideas, but you should implement. Until and unless, nobody will know that you have this kind of ideas. So that is having more demand. It is not like simply presenting. I'm going and say, I have this, you do presentation here, you do presentation. No. You actually have to work on it. You need to develop something, at least a prototype, and you have to exhibit it, either in hackathons or somewhere, so that people will look at it and come to you. But I will say a lot of demands are there for the idea. Okay.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am, for this very informative session. Such a detailed explanation. Once again, thank you very much, ma'am, for sharing your knowledge.
Thank you, ma'am.
And okay, I would like to call Monica R to give vote of thanks.
A warm and cherished afternoon to our most valued, honorable resource person, Professor Aruna Devi, principal, and faculty members, and my dear friends, everyone present here. It is my privilege to propose a vote of thanks and acknowledge the contribution thanks of those who work hard to make this virtual seminar grand success. This is Monica from 2nd BSc. I am here to give the vote of thanks for today's virtual seminar on IoT. Firstly, we are heartily thankful to our beloved principal, Professor Jairam Reddy sir, who always supporting us in any activities we do. Thank you, sir. I take this time to thank our resource person, Professor Aruna ma'am, for sharing her knowledge on IoT with all of us. This virtual seminar was really useful to us, ma'am. We learned more things on IoT. Thank you, ma'am. I wholeheartedly thank our beloved HOD, Dr. Hemila ma'am, who made this virtual seminar possible for us. And also we thank all faculty members, teaching and non-teaching staff, who made this seminar to reach to us. Thank you to all. Last but not least, without you that no program will succeed. Friends, thank you to all who were present here and make seminar successfully. Thank you all. Kindly fill the feedback sharing in the chat box. Thank you. Have a nice day.
It's a really wonderful session, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much.
Thank you.